What we do in prostate cancer, so if I drop the dose of P10 to 50%, I get hyperplasia. If I drop it completely to zero, I get PIN, which is a benign type of tumor, it's not invasive. Why? Because as I showed you before, there is a barrier, a senescence break, which opposes the possibility of this tumor to go from this stage to prostate cancer. If we remove this barrier, because we get a second mutation in, for instance, P53, as I showed you at the beginning, or in P27, which is another gene, this tumor can progress. So the idea of prosenescent therapy is just to reinforce that barrier that I showed you at the beginning. And so what we show, for instance, that knowing these specific important genetic mediator, it's possible to target them with small molecules, so with inhibitors, which are selective inhibitors, for instance, of this gene here. And when you do this game, this is a beta-gal staining, for instance, a normal in a P10 null. And this is what's happened when we use these compounds, which increase really dramatically the senescence response. So it's the first demonstration that if you use compounds which target genes which are involved in senescence, we can have a therapeutic benefit. Okay? Again, this slide shows you that prosenescent therapy of cancer is just to reinforce this barrier which can happen in some specific tumor. So the tumor cannot progress and we don't develop, for instance, metastasis or aggressive type of tumor. What also Pierpaoli showed in a recent paper is that even in aggressive type of tumors, so tumors that have lost, for instance, the possibility to undergo to senescence because they have accumulated different type of mutation, we can even think to reactivate this senescence response by inhibition of different genes. So in other words, what I want to show you is that prosenescent therapy for cancer does not work only in a scenario in which the tumor is still localized and benign, but also in tumors which are very, very aggressive, and just knowing the genetic regulator of this, we can reactivate the senescence response. This is the paper that Pierpaolo published recently, also in 2010, in which using this inhibitor, which is called SKIP2 inhibitor, that we made in the lab, he was able to drive a senescence even in tumors which are super aggressive and actually coming from a metastasis of a patient. So another aspect of this novel therapeutic approach that we would like to pursue in the lab and also for therapeutic application is that this type of treatment seems to be more selective compared to chemoradiotherapy. Indeed, what we recently show is that if you treat cell with this inhibitor here in cell that are P10 null, I mean, you have a gain of a cell which are positive. On the contrary, in another type of tumor which that is driven by RAS, which is another important oncogene, this difference is very, very small and not statistically significant. More important, that there is an effect on the control cells, so normal cells, but this effect is not so important. So what we show also that using another inhibitor, which is, by the way, a P10 inhibitor. This is a very funny story because to publish this, it was really, very tough. In other words, it was an idea of Pierpaolo. He invented an inhibitor of P10. And again, P10 is a tumor suppressor gene, so people were thinking we were crazy to downregulate even further a tumor suppressor gene. I told you at the beginning that the dosage is very important. In the majority of tumor, P10 is 50%, right? And so we were saying, okay, let's target this other 50% with an inhibitor of this tumor suppressor. Let's push it to zero, and let's see if we can have a therapeutic benefit. And we created, together with the UK, an inhibitor which is called Vopic that is now used for anti-diabetic reason. I don't know why. And when we treat the cell that are 50% P10, we were able to trigger senescence in this cell, whereas not in P10 wild type, so in P10 normal cell. Why this happened? Because essentially this inhibitor is not a complete inhibitor of P10, but just a partial inhibitor of P10. After we went on and we characterized different cell line on the basis of P10 and P53, and what we did is to do xenograft mouse model that we don't like to do, but we use it in this case, and what we observed that this inhibitor was even effective in treating this type of cell here, which have very low level of P10, and that are wild type for this other gene that is called P53. So knowing the genome, you can really go with the specific inhibitor at driving senescence and blocking, and this look like it's worked also in preclinical mouse model. So another effect of this senescence approach is that it's looked to be specific even for cell which cannot replicate, and as you know, I have a cartoon later, I mean, chemoradiotherapy not work efficiently in cell which are actively proliferating. Sorry, it worked very well in cells which are actively proliferating, but not in cells which do not proliferate. This is the reason why we think the tumor relapse. So what we show here that using this inhibitor, the P10, or downregulating the level of P10, we are able to drive senescence even cells that are predicted with acetylcholine, which is an inhibitor of cell cycle. In other words, I take a cell, which I stack pharmacologically, I inactivate P10, I drive senescence response, which is quite surprising. And what we did recently in Switzerland is to use neuroblastoma cell line. I didn't know anything about neuroblastoma, but also, by the way, neuroblastoma, it's a very aggressive tumor, which is characterized by MYC overexpression, which, by the way, is a senescence escaper, considered a very aggressive type of tumor. And when you use this P10 inhibition in this cell, and you go to sort for stem cell of putative cancer stem cell in this cell line, you have like 2.5% of cell which are positive to this marker of stem cell. In other words, if I take this and inject in a mice, this form a tumor, the rest do not form a tumor. So the treatment is able even to downregulate the percentage of this cell from 2.6% to 1.3%. So it looks like this type of treatment is working even in this context. This is a paper that show you that CMYC is amplification is actually a bad prognostic marker in patients, because if you have a MYC mutation or amplification, tumor escapes senescence in general. So just to tell you what's happened, when we use the VOPIC inhibitor, so the P10 inhibition, we overcome this resistance to senescence. So this looked to be very interesting, and we went on, and we just treat, these are examples, this other cell, cancer cell line with this inhibitor, and it looked like, although they have amplification in CMYC, they respond well to the treatment, so there is an inhibition of proliferation, also an upregulation of marker of senescence response. Another important aspect of this senescence is that we characterize that it happened without accumulation of DNA damage that usually can trigger additional mutation in tumor or a determinate escape in tumor. And so why this is important? Because we said, okay, we have a senescence response which is independent by DNA damage. This is a paradigm in senescence. You have to have DNA damage to have a senescent cell, and we showed that in our type of senescent, on the contrary, there was no DNA damage. So we said, okay, we don't have DNA damage, but we have senescence and high level of P53. What's happening if we try to combine this with the DNA damage agent? So what we are trying to do now is to combine this inhibitor of P10 with the compounds which can activate the DNA damage. And so we think that this novel therapeutic approach can be used also as adjuvant to chemo radiotherapy. In other words, we put the DNA damage in cells which are the tendency to begin senescence when we block the P10 allele. Indeed, what we did is just to combine this radiotherapy plus this inhibitor of P10, and you can see that we know, of course, that radiotherapy works very well, but when we use in combination, there is a very strong growth arrest, and by the way, there is also an upregulation of P53, which is important for senescence, which is more evident that with the radiotherapy alone. So this is just a cartoon to show you the difference between our pro-senescent therapy for cancer and the chemoradiotherapy approach. In other words, with white, we have designed here the cell which are actively proliferating. Chemoradiotherapy kill very well this cell, but doesn't touch the stem cell, so the quiescent cancer stem cell. And what's happened after chemoradiotherapy that we end up to select for this cell, so we have like tumor relapse after normal chemoradiotherapy. That's the reason why people die. On the contrary, what we want to do with pro-senescent therapy for cancer, we want to irreversibly arrest this cell, and we show that this is possible, so proliferating cell, but also to arrest irreversibly this cell, which are quiescent cancer stem cell. In this way, with such approach, what we want to do is to let expire the tumor, so the tumor cannot repopulate. This approach, we are trying to develop a modality to study this. What Pierpaolo showed and what we are also investigating, even if this tumor accumulates a secondary mutation that let the tumor be senescence resistant, we can reactivate this senescence status by inactivating, for instance, additional genes. So again, this therapeutic approach will work also in this scenario. And this is what we are trying to do with the therapeutic application of this approach.